Welcome to the 2016 Sixth Annual Movie Awards.
Wayland, God bless you. You're coming up with some good students. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to teach you as well.
well. One last thing I want to let you know. All your tickets, at the end of the evening, after you see these great films, you want to take your ticket and put it in the movie you feel is best. Because we do have a People's Choice Award at the end of the evening. When you walk out the doors, right on your left, you see three silver boxes with the name of the movie. Just put your ticket in there, and then we tally them and give them the last award of the evening. Okay? With that being said, I'm going to actually pass it on now to my friend here, our host for the evening, William. Congratulations.
All right. My name is William Paik, and I will be your host for this evening. Tonight, you will see the culmination of a year's worth of efforts. A year of writing, a year of editing, a year of filming, a year of yelling at Jackson Diani. Tonight, you will see some great movies, some absolutely amazing movies, some incredible movies, and Jason's movies. So, without further ado, let me introduce the first film. Which is...
What's the director?
Oh, the first director is... Wait, who's the first director?
Which is Jason?
Jason.
Jason
Mott. Everyone hide your kids.
Choreography for it because I have 6 years of mixed martial arts training. I used it to do some of the choreography in this, and I hope you guys enjoy. Thank you.
Cool, man. I don't want to play.
I saw you eyeing my girl. Don't you deny it. Watch your mouth next time, bitch.
Welcome to Ashbourne High School. I hate this town. Ever since my father passed away, nothing is the same. We moved to Ashbourne, a shithole excuse for a town. But you get used to it, or have to. See what I mean? The town became a mess after an oil spill back in 09 that defamed the name Ashbourne. Then all the wealthy left and the scum moved in. The towns around didn't care or even want to know, long as there was no overspill into their precious white picket communities.
I got my meeting.
The school was like the jungle. The upperclassmen, the lions, the fragile gazelle underclassmen, and the teachers were the trees, bystanders to it, turning a blind eye to the violence and chaos. But hey, at least the school is nice. They built it before the oil spill incident, so now you can look at some nice tiles before you pass out.
This is bullshit. All I did was help Lily with her math homework, and then Chad comes out of nowhere saying how I was sweet-talking his girl.
So what happened next?
This happened. Well, are you gonna do anything about it?
Of course, I'll speak to Chad.
Thank you.
New kid got initiation?
Yes, sir, but he isn't with us yet. But in a couple of weeks, he will be.
Good. What about the shipments?
They got through with no problems. The pigs can't touch it.
That's exactly what I want to hear, Miss Clarence. That's exactly what I want to hear. Hey, you keep up this good work, and you'll get your money.
Dad?
Will, go get your mother.
Little Will? You stay right here and see just how much of a coward your dad really is.
Run away!
Sandman's having matches to see the new prospects.
Who's that?
Sandman? He runs the show around here. And the fight leader.
Lisa, why are you helping this guy? He's only keeping me around for eye candy.
Better eye candy than this. Sorry.
I'm fine.
Listen, maybe if he went, it'd get Chad off your back.
I seriously doubt that.
And I really hope you find a way to get Chad off your back. But I really gotta get back to handing these flags out, or I'm gonna be in huge trouble. Thank you. See you around the world.
See you, Lisa.
Watch where you're going.
Look, man, I'm sorry.
I heard you had a little chat with our principal.
And? You shouldn't try anything unless you want to speed up your expulsion process.
You really think they're going to expel me? You really don't get it, do you, Will?
What do you mean?
No one is going to help you. The administration here is a joke. They're just puppets in a bigger game. So here's the deal. I'll give you one free shot.
Why?
Because I'm gonna kick your ass. Run, Will! Run! I'll be right behind you! Oh, come on, Will!
I have a hunch Miss Foreman won't mind if I cut class.
What's your problem, dude?
Back off.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. Right, get out of here before anyone sees.
Due to recent budget cuts, we will have a few less computers in the lab, so please pair up during class activities.
Lisa, not sure what she did. Something about stealing from the boss man. But if you ask me, she found out.
That's too bad. She was nice. I liked her.
You'd say that about any girl after your 4-month dry spell.
I need to check up on some shipments. I'll see you around.
I really shouldn't get involved. I'll just call the cops or something. Like they'll do anything.
Let me go. What do you think you're doing?
I need answers.
You're not gonna get any, so how about this? I think you've just made a mistake, so if you let me go now, Sandman won't have to hear about any of this.
Where is Lisa?
Why do you care?
All right. I'll tell you.
You got some nerve showing up here, Will.
Good to see you too, Chad.
Do you have some kind of death wish?
I need to talk to Lisa.
I can't do that. Sandman's dealing with her.
Come on, Chad. She's an innocent girl.
They're not my rules. I'm sorry.
I know you aren't like that. Please let me talk to her.
You don't know me. Now back off before Sandman finds you here.
Did somebody say my name?
That was me, boss.
You must be Will. It is so good to meet you.
Good to meet you too, Mr. Sandman.
Call me Chris.
Okay, Chris. You took my friend Lisa, and I need you to let her go.
Deal.
Wait, what?
It's a deal, but you're gonna need to participate in the school's Primal Fight League.
You want me to fight for entertainment?
Well, yeah, there's that, but there's some added bonuses.
What exactly do I have to do?
Shadow over here will help you out. You win 3 consecutive fights, and I'll let Lisa go. With enough money for you and your mother to leave this town for good. Come on, Will, we both know that's what you want.
Deal.
Alright, so this is a treadmill. Keep your cardio up. Not all fights are gonna end that fast. We got some mats to practice jiu-jitsu, double end bag to work striking, and some simple weights to keep strong. It's not pretty, but you'll be a much better fighter if you've got a place to train and someone to train you.
Thanks. You mean you?
Good guess. Now I've got to lay down some rules for the Primal League.
Ha ha ha.
What's so funny?
Are you trying to tell me that there are rules to defending my life?
Yes. Now shut up. There's no hits to the groin, no biting, no scratching, no hair pulling, no beating anyone up after they have been knocked out or have tapped out, no eye gouges, no ear pulling. Anything else? No, that's it for now.
They say there's no honor in Ashborn.
We aren't complete monsters.
What is this Primal Fight League anyway?
Basically, it's regulated fights between students with cash awards. It's the only sport in Ashborn. All the other sports were cut after the oil spill, and then Sandman came and offered this. It's not pretty, but the students need money, and he offered the opportunity.
Why do they call him Sandman, anyway?
Enough questions. Let's get to training.
Right, yeah.
Alright, get your foot back. Hands up. Keep them up. Head down. Alright. There's a jab, but when you come in for the jab, I want you to turn. I want you to come in and just turn.
I promise you.
What do you think you're doing? Trying to save some poor kid. The only saving you should be doing is saving your own ass. You have 3 fights, and if you're not 100% for those, you will not make it.
But
no fighting. Understood? Let's go. Got to stop backing up.
I know, I'm sorry. I see the punches and I back up naturally.
Will, do you know why I love fighting so much?
Other than it being the only sport here?
I love fighting because it's the only sport where it is the ultimate competition between 2 people. If you win, you get all the glory. And if you lose, there's no one to blame but yourself.
Why are you telling me all this?
Because in life, just like in fighting, you can back up, and it may seem like a viable option, but at some point, you have to stand and fight, or you'll find yourself in a corner with no options.
I see. But what can I do instead of backing up?
You gotta cut the angle. Come at him from a different angle while still staying within your range. Come on, I'll show you. Alright, so you're gonna throw, get in your stance. Alright, you're gonna throw a slow left jab. You slip down, and when that happens, you have this whole side wide open. Just hit him right there and get out quick. Just get some quick, right? Slow left jab, slip down, pop.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Alright. Now, remember, use ducks and slips. And if you're gonna back up, remember, come right back. Keep it simple, alright? 1-2, just like we practiced. What?
May the fighters try, meet in the middle, and tap their fist.
Hey, Max.
Fight!
Come on, get your hands off.
Sorry.
I'm fine.
I'm really sorry. Is there any way I can make it up to you?
You could start by telling me your name.
Right. I'm Olivia.
Will. Nice to meet someone who isn't an asshole.
You don't know me, I could be. Oh,
nah, you seem like good people.
Good people do bad things.
True. Well, I actually want to ask you how you learn to fight so well.
Through trial and error in the fight league.
You're in the fight league?
Yep. Been fighting since I was a kid.
Don't you hate it? Having to fight all the time?
There are days when I don't feel like fighting. But it puts food on the table, so I can't really complain.
Fair. I should have been to class. See you around?
Sure. They're onto us. FBI caught the last shipment. It's a matter of time before someone squeals.
I understand. Yes.
We need everything out by this Friday, including us. I know another fight is due,
but if we don't get out of here, we'll get arrested. Fine. We'll have the fight. But as soon as it's over, we have to get out of here.
Come on, three more. Nice. Good job. So, I got some news on your fight next Friday.
Nice! Who's he?
It's a she. And I'm not happy about it, but it's not my call.
Not cool.
Her name's Olivia.
I'm not gonna fight her.
Why?
Other than it being completely wrong, she's my friend.
You can't let your emotions control you.
It's plain wrong, Chad.
You're right, but what are you gonna do? If you don't fight, you get punished.
I'll think of something.
No, you won't. You'll fight.
What are the shipments, Chad?
What are you talking about?
Don't play stupid with me, Chad. I know there's something fishy going on in this school. And if you don't help me out, you're gonna get caught in the fallout.
What fallout are you talking about?
I overheard the principal talking to Sandman.
They're gonna get the rest of the shipments and get out by Friday after the fight.
Now, why would they do that?
The FBI. They know. I'm guessing they're gonna raid the school the following Monday.
Why should I believe you?
Because I wouldn't lie to you, Chad. I know the kind of person you are. You saved Lisa the other day. You're not like them.
You don't know me, Will.
Good people can do bad things.
That doesn't mean that they can't change.
What's the plan?
Move.
What's with the hostility?
Maybe it's because you're trying to take my head off tomorrow.
It's actually what I wanted to talk to you about.
What's there to talk about?
I don't want to fight you.
I don't want to fight you either. But what can we do?
I have a plan.
You sure this will work?
Nope.
That makes me feel a lot better.
It'll be okay, it'll work. Just stick to the plan.
May the fighters rise, meet in the middle, and tap their fists. Fight!
He's not buying it.
Chad, you good?
Fine.
Let's go.
These shipments were full of school equipment. I had no idea.
No one did.
Hey guys, something over here! You guys need to leave, now!
Well, you guys had to ruin everything. You had to ask all those questions.
Put the gun down, Chris.
Well, what, Will?
What's your end goal here? If you leave now, you can still get away. Maybe leave the country? Do you really want to face murder charges as well?
I can deal with that.
Run!
Something that Ashbourne taught me was that you don't need people to like you. You just need them to respect you.
It's Fight of the Light, we finna get lit tonight, cause we're gonna...
Comfortable, we're going to be here for a while.
Look, I may be in high school, but I know my rights. You can't just keep me here as long as you like.
Oh, we can. Especially if it involves a serious crime.
Well, then you got the wrong guy.
Really? That's interesting. Your father says you're a really good black hat, or hacker, whichever you prefer.
So what? Everybody needs a hobby.
Oh, Andrew, I don't think you get it. I could arrest you right here and right now. But I won't. So why don't you return the favor and answer my questions, all right?
Fine. What do you want to know?
What occurred over the course of this past week at your high school?
I studied all night for that quiz 2 days ago. Thinking I'd ace it, I stopped and went to bed. Kind of wishing I'd spent more time studying.
Oh, come on. What'd you get?
A C.
Oh, hey, that's good, right?
No. How could you say that? Oh, wait. I forgot. Your grades are all A's. You never experienced the pain of a C.
Honestly, I don't even care about my grades.
Really? You should. They're your future.
Not really.
You know, I'd do anything to get the kind of grades you get. Well, see ya.
Yeah, see ya.
Hey, Andrew. What's happening?
Hey, Sam.
So, how's the hacking going?
You stupid. Don't talk about that here.
Sorry. So how's it going?
It's good, actually. I've kind of made my business known around school. In fact, I'm meeting with a kid in the SLC in a few minutes.
That's good. Hey, you think this time you could teach me a few tricks?
Look, Sam, you're my friend and all, but you're not exactly the kind of girl who would understand this tech stuff.
Just give me a shot, please. I know I'm not the smartest person, but I can still learn.
Maybe another time. I gotta go. See ya, Sam.
Yeah, see ya.
Hey, someone said that you were the guy who...
Yes. Shut up. Sit. All right, look. This only works if you got the money.
I got it, yeah.
There's just one condition. You can't tell.
Yeah, sure.
It's easy to change your grades once. It's even easier to change them back. You got it?
Alright, I got it.
Good. Got the money in your name, right there. Walk away.
Hey, Jessica, how was the meeting with Mr. Clark?
It was fine.
Shit. Another firewall. I hate when the school does this.
A firewall? Let me give it a try.
Be my guest.
And done. You should be all set.
Wow. That was fast. Thanks. Weird.
McCarthy, office, now!
Oh, Andrew. Hacking is a serious offense, not to mention the fact that you lied to me.
Hey, I didn't hack anyone, okay? I was being hacked.
What about that student whose grade you changed?
That was a one-time thing.
Understand. And I'll forgive you for now. Now, what happened after the events that occurred at the shop?
Hacking into the school system to change your grades?
Mr. Clark, I wasn't the one who hacked the school system, okay? I was being hacked. Someone was changing my grades and making them worse.
That's not how the school sees it. They're gonna suspend you next week.
That's outrageous. I wasn't even the one who committed the crime, and I'm still the one receiving the punishment.
Look it, Andrew, I like you. I don't like to see this happening to you, but there's nothing we can do.
Look. Mr. Clark, you gotta give me a chance. I'm innocent.
Well, maybe there's one thing we can do.
Any?
You're technically not going to be suspended till Monday, which basically gives you to 2:15 on Friday. If you can find some evidence to prove yourself innocent, you're all set.
Deal, I'll do it.
Oh, you gotta do me one favor.
Yeah?
When you get the evidence, email me right away, okay?
Okay.
All right. Let's get out of here. Good luck.
Thank you.
You'll need it.
Moron.
Stupid kids.
Andrew?
Not now, Jessica.
Are you okay? You seem kind of stressed. Maybe I could help with your...
Listen. Now is really not a good time, okay? I'll talk to you later.
Sorry. I'll talk to you later.
Jessica, she hacked me and then she turned me into Mr. Clark.
That sounds serious. Sounds like you two need some couples therapy or something.
Haha, real funny. Your jokes aren't exactly helping me right now.
Okay, fine. Just trying to lighten the mood, that's all.
Lighten the mood when I'm not being hacked by my best friend and when I'm also not on the hot seat for being suspended.
Do what?
You're the one who hacked my account, you changed my grades, you turned me into Mr. Clark, you set me up!
No, Andrew, it's not what it seems
like. How did you do this to me? I thought we were friends. You know, we've known each other since the third grade. I took you to prom, for God's sake, and this is how you repay me?
Andrew, I wanted to warn you, I really did. I just didn't know how to.
What?
Remember my meeting with Mr. Clark?
Yes.
Well, as I told you before, it was really weird.
Hello, Jessica. How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
Listen, I hate to do this to you, but I double booked and I have another meeting with the principal. Would you mind waiting here?
No, that's fine.
Thank you so much. I'll be right back, okay?
Okay.
All right.
Hey, Jessica.
Hey, Sam.
Is Mr. Clark here?
No, he just left my meeting for another meeting. Just my luck, I guess.
Shoot. I was really hoping to meet with him before my next class.
I bet you can meet with him at another time.
I guess. So, you and Andrew.
What about me and Andrew?
Guys, you know, dating yet?
Me and Andrew, dating. No, that'll be the day. We're just friends.
Oh, that's interesting.
Why is that?
Well, if you're not gonna ask him out, I might as well.
Oh, I didn't know you liked him.
Well, I've just been waiting for the right moment, but I've liked him for quite a while now.
Really?
Yeah, since freshman year, I think. It doesn't matter, though. I'm still gonna get him to ask me out.
I don't know. I was
shoot. How do I stop this thing? Andrew's going to be so pissed.
Why didn't you tell me any of this?
I didn't know how to, but it doesn't matter now because you know.
No, you don't understand.
Jessica Hall to the main office. Jessica Hall
to the main office now.
I'm sorry. I never meant for any of this to happen to you.
I know. Just save yourself.
From what?
I don't know, but whoever it is, they're coming for you now.
So Jessica was your hacker. That's cold.
No. No, she wasn't. She was just trying to warn me.
About what?
Andrew.
Sam, this isn't a good time.
Actually, Andrew, this is the perfect time. You see, Andrew, you hurt me.
What? What are you talking about?
Yes, Andrew, you hurt me. Watching you have everything. The grades, the hacking, the girl.
Sam, what are you talking about?
You're a smart kid. I know you can figure this out on your own, but I'll tell you anyway. See, it's really hard to watch someone you really like go ahead and flirt with another girl. Like, does it have to be Jessica?
Sam, Jessica and I are just friends.
I know you two are more than just friends. That's how I have to make sure you got what was coming to you.
Sam, what are you saying?
Andrew, so naive. I hacked you. I turned you into Mr. Clark. I made you think that Jessica was the one who hacked you.
It was you? Why are you doing this to me?
You hurt me! How many times do I have to tell you? You got the best grades in the school while I sat there failing every class. But more importantly, you wouldn't share any of your hacking secrets with me, your friend.
Sam, I didn't know, okay? I didn't—
Shut up! I'm done listening to your nonsense.
Sam, please just listen to me.
No. If you thought taking away your grades was bad, what comes next will be much worse.
Sam, what are you about to do?
I'm gonna take away your identity. Everything that was Andrew McCarthy will be gone forever. Then, when you felt the pain of having everything taken away from you, you could tell me you're sorry. Where is it?
Looking for this?
Where did you get that?
My so-called girlfriend.
Flash drive.
Sorry, Sam. Look, I didn't want to have to do this to you. I've always thought of you as my friend. But I think it's time the hacking at this school stopped. Sam, I'm sorry. Maybe one day, when all this is over, we can be friends again.
So that's my story. I used the virus on Sam's identity. I turned her in to the paper and the local authorities, and then I deleted every hacking program I own. I haven't hacked anything since.
Interesting story. But I'm afraid your hacking days are far from over, Andrew.
What's that supposed to mean?
Andrew? I work for the FBI.
That's a little serious for me.
You're bigger in the eyes of the FBI than you may think.
What does the FBI want with someone like me?
I'm glad you asked. You see, a few years ago, we had a case pop up about a girl who lived a few towns over from you. She found these glasses that somehow made her smarter, and before we knew it, she was hired to steal our intel. She did this with nothing but a computer and a pair of golden spectacles.
So what do you want me to do?
We want you to use your hacking skills to steal back our intel and destroy the virus on our networks. So, what's your decision?
Who is that? The power of Christ compels you!
Now! Now!
this myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste.
None of us anticipated the gravity of the events that would take place that day, setting the craziness in motion.
I was around when Jesus Christ had his moments of doubt and pain.
I'm not this kid. That diffident Pisces is Lucas Trevino, a sucker for love.
Seal his face.
I'm just here to recount the mysterious circumstances in the small town of Stoneville that year. The rise of a centuries-old satanic witch, and the tragic love story between two friends I had in high school.
Hey, Lucas.
Hey, Lucy, I'll see you after school. Stuck around St.
Petersburg when I saw so it begins.
That's insane. Do you know who saw him last?
No. The police asked me, but I didn't even know he was there.
I made out with him that night.
Actually?
Don't really remember.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Lucas.
I feel so weird about it now.
About what?
She hooked up with Johnny at my party on Saturday. Were you there?
No, I couldn't make it.
You did hear about Johnny, though, right?
No, what about him?
No one's seen him since the party.
Johnny Boyce? You're kidding.
No, we're not. I got to go to the police station for questioning.
You guys, I'm leaving. Bye.
Bye.
Pick you up after school?
Text me.
See you, Kayla.
Bye, Lucas.
See ya. Dude, guess what?
Dude, you just see that? Mary was all over you.
You think?
Doesn't matter. I have better news.
Do tell.
Lucy and I are hanging out after school today.
Lucy McLean? There you go, bro.
All right, don't get too excited yet. I mean, we're partners for this English project. She asked me to hang out afterwards and work on it a little bit.
At least you'll be in the presence of estrogen. We talked about this. Just be cool. Keep the conversation flowing.
So the thesis I have is basically that Romeo and Juliet's love is inevitably doomed from the start because of the world around them and their own desperate dependence on one another. Or some BS like that.
That sounds fine. Inevitably doomed from the start. I like that. You got a record player?
Hell yeah. Everything sounds better on vinyl.
Okay, well, I like your thesis, but I was thinking that we could talk a little bit more how they...
Yes, sir.
What?
Kiss me.
Okay.
Well, glad we got that out of the way.
What do you mean?
Well, you couldn't take your eyes off me, so I figure it's best to get the sexual tension out of the way.
Right.
You kiss better than Johnny.
Oh, Johnny Boyce?
Yeah, he was always a little too aggressive with it, you know? Most of the time it's a turn-off for me when things get too sloppy.
Yeah.
But with you, it wasn't too forceful, more gentle. Apprehensive. I like that. It leaves a lingering desire for more.
Oh.
This doesn't have to be awkward between us, you know. Most people have this tendency to withhold their feelings from one another. Like, let's just be totally open with each other, man. Say whatever's on your mind.
Okay, well, I don't know. I mean, I definitely wasn't expecting that to happen.
Yeah, and?
So, are you and Johnny Boyce like a thing?
There we go. Poor Johnny. We were casually hooking up this past year, but it was nothing serious. I'm just not into committed relationships, and Johnny was always a little too obsessive. I just need my independence, you know? Life's about freedom.
Right. So, speaking of Johnny, it's been 3 days now. What do you think about all this?
I don't know.
I mean, I know it's gotta be a joke, but everyone's been talking about the whole Stonebell witch thing.
I know. I think that's so funny.
It's like she's seeking her revenge, coming after one of us.
I mean, it's not impossible. Do you believe?
In what?
The Stonebell witch.
No? What, do you?
Yes! I love those crazy urban legends.
I mean, that story always did scare the hell out of me as a kid.
Even with all those horror movies you'd watch?
Okay, the movies weren't that scary. The visuals were intriguing, but it's more about what you can't see that's scary.
Let me interject real quick. So basically, in the 1850s, there was this crazy old lady who everyone hated here in Stonebell, Mass., named Lucinda Mason. Allegedly, she molested some local boy. The villagers found out and accused her of being a witch. Now, legend goes that moments before they executed her, she put a curse on our town, claiming that once every 50 years for the rest of eternity or whatever, she would rise from the grave to haunt Stonebell and kidnap a child for barbaric slaughter. Or so the story goes.
Dude, so yesterday at Lucy's?
Yeah?
Yeah.
No.
Lucas Trevino is kind of cute.
I think he's so hot.
I would.
No, you didn't.
Son of a bitch.
How was it?
I mean, it wasn't anything crazy, but yeah, we hooked up.
He came over yesterday to work on an English paper.
And?
The poor kid was so uncomfortable. I asked him to kiss me. Caught him so off guard.
You bitch. You bitch. Teasing him like that.
I'm the devil.
She came on to me, you know what I'm saying?
So are you guys a thing now or what?
I mean, she was asking for more.
He had no idea what he was doing, but he's a sweet kid.
Would you hook up with him for real?
Maybe.
Lucy, you didn't clean the litter box again.
I'm sorry, Dad.
Save your sorries. Get down here now. I'm tired of this.
It's like one of those voodoo doll things from the movies, used in witchcraft and all that.
Any idea how this got in your locker?
No clue, but it reminded me of the stuff that we were talking about yesterday. You know, all this weird stuff going on around town. I find this, Johnny disappears, there's those missing pets.
Believe me, I know. Listen, Lucas. You're gonna think I'm crazy.
No, go ahead. Say whatever you want.
Okay, the other day, when I said I believed in the Stonebell Witch...
Yeah?
I seriously think that legend might be true. You said you wouldn't think I'm crazy! You're looking at me like I'm crazy!
No, continue. I'm very interested.
Okay, then follow me. So, I've been doing some research. About 50 years ago, here on Stonebell, a local high schooler named Frank Dunbar disappeared from his house in the middle of the night. He lived over on Sycamore. No one knows what happened. His body was never found. The police reported dozens of missing pets in the weeks prior, similar satanic imagery and bad omens appearing in public places.
That's insane.
So I dug even further back. The details are more obscure, but exactly 50 years before that, another case of a kid who disappeared in the middle of the night. The locals all feared it was the wrath of the Stonebell Witch.
If all that history is true, damn, it is hard to call it coincidental.
Look, I don't know what I believe, But this is a small town, and weird occurrences like this don't happen often. Something's going on, and when I look at all of this, the supernatural doesn't seem as far-fetched.
Yeah, I suppose. So if, there's a Stonebell witch, you think it took Johnny?
When I say it out loud, I realize how insane it sounds. Honestly, maybe I'm just really worried about the kid.
I'll help you find out what happened to him, Lucy, and everything that's going on.
You think I'm crazy?
I don't think you're crazy.
This bitch is crazy!
Bennett.
I don't know. I think she's just really worried about what happened to Johnny, which I can totally understand.
Dude, do not get mixed up in this.
You don't want to get in between another girl's relationship with another guy. And I know, Lucy.
It's not about their relationship. It's about figuring out what's behind all these weird patterns going on around town, including the missing kid. I mean, he's out there somewhere right now.
The cops will figure it out.
It's not your job to be running around helping this girl find some kid she used to bang. And just because he's missing doesn't mean the Stonebell freaking witch got him. You don't actually believe that, do you?
No, of course not. I don't think she does either.
I don't know, man. I don't know. I'd stay out of her personal stuff. Like, it's cool if you just want to get with her, but the things I've heard.
I really like this girl.
I know.
Excuse me, can we look through the town newspapers and files from 1956, particularly around the time when Frank Dunbar went missing?
And what is this for?
School project.
1956?
Yes.
Here you go. Good luck.
Thanks.
Check this out, an old town map. Lucinda Mason's burial site.
It looks like someone drew that in there. There's no cemetery back there.
Lucinda Mason. That's the name of the woman the town executed in the 1800s. The real Stonebell Witch.
So you think this
is the witch's grave? We gotta find this place.
No. No, I don't. This place doesn't exist.
It's the only lead we've got.
Lucy, just because Johnny's missing doesn't mean the Stonebell freaking witch abducted him.
You think I'm crazy? You've been talking to your friends about me, haven't you?
No. No, I haven't.
I bet they tell you how I'm this messed up girl with issues.
No, not at all. Oh, damn it. Terrible words.
Listen, you need to understand that I'm not a happy person, okay? I'm not some fun, brighten your day, positive type of girl.
Lucy. I think you're the coolest, most genuine girl I've ever met. And
I'm not, Lucas. I'm really not. But thank you so much.
I'll drive you home now.
I'm always here if you need to talk. I mean, if you need help or just need someone to talk to.
Thanks, Lucas. You're the sweetest. Oh, God. Save me from my dad.
Has he been waiting for you to get home?
He doesn't care when I get home. Can't stand me.
Well, if you don't have to be home, then you doing anything tonight? You want to come over?
I'd love to.
I like this.
It's a classic.
I don't mean the movie.
Thank you.
Johnny Boyce.
Oh, hey guys.
Johnny, you're back. What's going on, man?
I've been out for a couple weeks.
Yeah, we know.
Where have you been? People have been so worried. I've been so worried.
I did something kind of stupid at Mary's party. I took some acid.
You left the party early.
Yeah, I went out for a walk. You know, catch some fresh air. I kind of felt sick.
Where'd you go?
I went to the woods.
Went real deep.
I heard some noises. I don't know what happened next. Police found me there several days later, knocked out, and been at home since.
Man, so sorry. Several days, it's horrible. Do you remember anything?
It's all pitch black. I remember I had this nightmare. There were these people in robes. They were chanting
all... You said you heard noises when you first entered the woods. What did you hear?
It was this high-pitched laughter echoing all around me. I don't know, man. I was tripping.
Are you sure you know where we're going?
According to this map, it's just up past Taylor Creek.
I don't understand how that kid lasted multiple days out in these woods. 200 years of weather and erosion. It's a lost cause.
What's that?
What?
Oh my God.
All those missing neighborhood pets. Looks like someone's been camping out here.
Lucinda Mason. May her soul remain forever trapped beneath this soil.
This is nuts.
Guess she isn't under the soil anymore.
Whatever this is, we gotta tell the police about this.
No, no police. Let's just keep it between us until we figure out everything else that's going on.
I don't like this.
Scared, Lucas?
Never afraid of the things I can see. Remember?
Right, the horror movies. I just want to stay here with you forever.
Lucy, don't mess with me right now. Let's just get out of here. So, tomorrow night they're doing a rerun of the original Nightmare on Elm Street at the theater. Would you want to go?
Are you asking me on a date?
I mean, I guess you could look at it that way. I just thought it'd be fun, you know, get our minds off the whole witch thing.
Yeah, sure, I'd love to.
Wait, really? Okay, great. But I thought you weren't into the whole dating thing.
Yeah, me too. I'll see you tomorrow night.
I'll catch you at 8.
Life's crazy.
Lucas!
Yeah?
Have you seen the dog?
No, I just got home. Why?
We haven't seen her all day. It looks like she ran off.
Oh, God. Thank you.
Lucy! Yo, Lucy! Shit!
We're sorry. The number you are calling was blocked. Your call cannot be completed as dialed.
God.
No police, Lucas. Just you. Meet us at my grave.
Where's my girlfriend?
Should be rising from the grave any minute now. We've made all the preparations.
You're messing with me. This is one sick prank, Lucy.
Lucas, don't start. Just trust me. I'm telling you the truth. You know how honest I am.
Honest? Honest, Lucy? Who are these people?
The Amare clan. They're a satanic cult.
Why?
These people understand me. They're gonna bring me to salvation.
You're a psycho. You're literally insane.
Don't you say that! I know that's not how you feel about me. You love me. Remember when you said you'd always be here for me? When you'd always help me? Well, you can help me now. You're gonna save me.
Lucy, this cult? They're responsible for all the crazy shit that's been going on. And you're with them?
They sent me to find someone, a boy from town. That was my ticket to get in. I chose Johnny, but when they surrounded him in the woods, they wouldn't accept him.
Why?
He lacked purity. They needed a chaste soul. It was my job to lure that soul in.
What are they gonna do to me?
You're our offering to the Stonebell Witch.
This is a dream. This is all a dream.
Just do it! Get it over with already!
I meant nothing to you.
No, Lucas, you...
You bitch! How could you do this to me? Who the fuck are you, Lucy?
I don't know. After tonight, I'll find the answer. I hope.
We can run away together. We can get away from these crazy people, and everything will be okay.
I can't, Lucas. It's too late.
I'll love you. I'll love you and make you happy and make life worth living. I'll get you help!
I can't love you.
Tell me, do you know what it means to be possessed by the devil? After tonight, you will be.
I'm so sorry! I'm so sorry we ever had to cross paths.
I'll keep this brief. The police had been in pursuit of the cult ever since they located Johnny. Apparently, Lucy's dad came home early that night and called the police when he found the note and blood left by the pool. The police figured out what was going on and finally busted in on the cult just in time. Lucy was sent away to live with relatives in Minnesota or something and get professional help. We never saw her again. As for Lucas, I don't think Lucy ever really left him.
Passion cannot be stifled. And when combined with the vigor of youth, it expresses itself through the most convenient outlet. Romeo and Juliet long to live for love and die for it. Lucas, you're zoning out. Have you heard a word I've said?
No.
All right, Lucas. We're going to have a little fun. Can you turn to page 227? I would like you to read the ending monologue of Romeo, please, to the class.
Ah, dear Juliet, why art thou yet so fair? Shall I believe that unsubstantial death is amorous?
Listen, Lucas. I'm always here if you ever need anything, if you need help or just want someone to talk to.
Kiss me.
Okay.
For fear of that, I still will stay with thee.
Thus concludes the tragic tale of the boy who got pulled into the darkness by the deceptive and self-destructive girl he was infatuated with. As for the Stonebell Witch, the myth was shut down once and for all after the cult was arrested. The tale became taboo.
And lips. O you the doors of breath, seal with a righteous kiss. A dateless bargain to engrossing death.
I don't know. I think the witch was there all along. Luring the naive, working her dark magic. One time, my man Lucas made out with her.
Scene, and I said, you can't do it unless you get their permission.
Well, Tom contacted the Rolling Stones, sent his film to them. They just okayed it last week. So he has the rights to that song.
What's up?
Let me just clarify exactly what we're going from set.
What's up? What's up? What's up?
Going from set.
This girl named Lucy, B-roll.
Yeah,
you know what's up?
Yeah, they go to the library, dig up some old town files, stuff like that. Kind of wanted to have that, but underneath it. Here, take a few steps forward, Tyler. So we can get that in the frame. Tyler, I'll have you just stand behind us and you can walk by. You just walk by and just, then you can get out of frame.
It's pretty good though, as far as that take goes.
That's how B-roll goes.
So for when
you're not directing.
What's up?
About 50 years ago, here on Stonebell, a local high schooler named Frank Dunbar disappeared from his house in the middle of the night. He lived over on Sycamore. No one knows what happened. His body was never found. The police reported dozens of missing pets in the weeks prior, similar satanic imagery, and bad omens appearing in public places.
That's insane.
So I dug even further back. The details are more obscured, but exactly 50 years before that, another case of a kid who disappeared in the middle of the night. The locals all feared it was the wrath of the Stonebell Witch.
If all that history is true, damn, it is hard to call it coincidental.
Just because he's missing doesn't mean the Stonebell freaking witch got him.
Lucas Trevino is kind of cute.
I think he's so hot.
Alan?
And what is this for?
School project.
I mean, it wasn't anything crazy, but yeah, we hooked up.
I don't know what I believe, but this is a small town, and weird occurrences like this don't happen often. Something's going on. When I look at all of this, the supernatural doesn't seem as far-fetched.
Core is really about, you know, choices and friendship. That's what I truly believe.
Yeah, your father. If you're like trying to think of something to give you that sense of an abusive father, you don't even have to like. I don't feel like you
trust him as back as.
Excuse me if I'm wrong.
Have you seen stink bugs? They still exist.
Like, what is right?
And then he'd be like, just kiss me. That'd be a movie. It'd be like some person trying to use that catch line.
So kiss me. Those aren't dinosaurs.
It's like you do it, so they're like, well, that depends on.
Hello, Andrew. I hope you're comfortable. We're going to be here for a while.
Look, I may be in high school, but I know my rights. You can't just keep me here as long as you like.
Oh, we can. Especially if it involves a serious crime.
Then you got the wrong guy.
Really? That's interesting. Your father says you're a really good black hat or hacker, whichever you prefer.
So what? Everybody needs a hobby.
Oh, Andrew, I don't think you get it. I could arrest you right here and right now. But I won't. So why don't you return the favor and answer my questions, all right?
I'm fine. What do you want to know?
What occurred over the course of this past week at your high school?
My name is Jason Mott, and this is my film, Fight or Flight. Fight or Flight takes place in a dystopian town called Ashmore.
And action.
Hey, Kevin.
Putt.
No. What do you think you're doing?
doing. You're trying to save some poor kid. The only saving you should be doing is saving your own ass.
Ricky, can you run and grab the blood thing?
Hey, guys!
Where is it?
It's, do you know where it is? Oh God, it's like the third cabinet down.
Okay, then we'll put some blood here.
Yeah. But like, my hat's gonna be here, so it's gonna be like dripping down.
That's fine, that's fine.
Put your head on.
And why don't we do it from Omar? Can you lift him up a little bit, and then it's almost like Tim regains his balance, gets down, and it's, okay?
All right, yeah.
Oh, I'm gonna shadow my knuckle with like just bloody.
Yeah, yeah. I do wanna like for the other fight scenes. I want like yours, yours and Tim's.
Oh,
yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Cut.
Is it this mic or is it that?
You can do it in this. That'll work. Because we get it from both, okay?
Run, Will.
Yeah, and action!
Watch your mouth next time, bitch.
Cut. All right, Jackson.
Yeah.
Gunshot. He's going to stop, look behind. You're going to say, run, Will. Omar's going to cover his ears.
Yeah. He's not like...
Yeah, also, the camera's not going to see it that up close. Okay. Yeah, there you go. Oh, that's sick. That's sick.
Miss Leahy, you read her email today?
Through the fire. Look. All right, today we're gonna go find out what's going on. Right, Miss Leahy, let's go. What? Where could they be? On the search for kids.
Are they out there?
Parkour.
Don't trip, dude.
Oh, God. Oh, parkour.
Will, do you know why I love fighting so much?
Other than it being the only sport here.
I love fighting because it's the only sport where it is the ultimate competition between two people. If you win, you get all the glory. And if you lose, there's no one to blame but yourself.
Why are you telling me all this?
Because in life, just like in fighting, you can back up, and it may seem like a viable option, but at some point, you have to stand and fight, or you'll find yourself in a corner with no options.
We need everything out by this Friday, including us.
Sense of what the kids do behind the scenes actually in order to create these films. The course is called Script to Screen. That's exactly what it is. The kids write all their original scripts. Then we have a panel of administration that actually comes in, and there's a sales pitch. Each person sells their script, just like in Hollywood. They don't have a lot of time. They have approximately 3 minutes. And then there's a PowerPoint presentation, whatever tools they want to do. Once the scripts are chosen, then they go into production. The students create shot lists, they create storyboards, they come up with their ideas. They work with the actors, they work with Mr. Weingartner for a couple of weeks. Then they do their casting. Once the casting's done, every day they shoot. Fourth quarter comes, they edit. And then we have this amazing film festival, and the kids actually are really proud of themselves. You get give them a nice little round of applause again. You got to see that. Now, all the hard work comes to this. I do want to let you know that Andrew Pelkington donated an award last year, and he's doing it again this year for best screenplay. He's giving the winner the final draft 9 for writing. So that's a free gift from Andrew Pelkington, who is an independent filmmaker himself. Give Andrew a nice round of applause. Again, that's his screenplay. And again, I want to thank you all for coming. I'm going to call William out now and take over. Let's hear it for William, our host.
Hi, I'm William Pate. Hope you all have a really nice day. I love movies. Movies are great.
Start with the award for the best score. All right. Is there some sort of drum roll or anything like that? Any sort of... There we go. All right, and the best score goes to...
Jackson Diani, Evan Hewitt, and Evan Clark! Evan, come on out too! Evan, come on out too. Are you dead? It says your name. Oh wait, for a girl named Lucy. Never mind. Did you work on this with him? Then come on out! I said the wrong word. Oh, I gotta wait. Oh, what? Oh, I see. Wait, so after the real runs, then I say the thing. Ah, I see.
There was only two on test today, sorry. Your director told me what to do.
He's not paying me. Just saying. Much to say, but this okay, Jason, they spelled my name right this time. So, I'd like to thank Flava Flav for being a constant source of musical inspiration. Kendrick Lamar.
Jake, you want to say something? A political speech or something?
I'm just happy to be here.
Guys, Jake really did a great job with this. We brought him in with a guitar amp, and he just, to the studio, and he just wrote stuff, and that was incredible in like one take or two. It was just amazing. He really deserves a lot of the credit. The award for best screenplay goes to?
The nominees are.
I'll get it eventually. Jason Mai for Fight or Flight. Is that it? Parker Bryant for Hacked. There we go. And Thomas Lee Q for This Girl Named Lucy. Lovely screenplays. Now the winner is? You said wait for the thing to play. You said wait for the thing to play. It's Thomas Lee Hugh for This Girl Named Lucy. You said wait for the thing. You have a few words, Thomas?
Thank you for everyone who came out tonight. Thank you to everyone who was involved in my film. All the actors, all the crew members who came to every shoot. Sebastian, he shot every frame that was in that movie, so I owe this film is half his, and as far as I'm concerned. So, and yeah, thank you again.
All right, next up, here comes the charm. The best supporting actress. The nominees are Veronica Golod for Fight or Flight.
Better eye candy than this. Sorry.
I'm fine.
Listen, maybe if you went, it'd get shot off your back.
FBI caught the last shipment. It's a matter of time before someone squeals. I understand.
While I sat there, failing every class. But more importantly, you wouldn't share any of your hacking secrets.
Hello, Andrew. I hope you're comfortable. We're going to be here for a while.
You can't just keep me here as long as you like.
But we can. Especially if it involves a serious crime.
Well, then you go.
And Cammy Winter.
Listen to this. I'm always here if you ever need anything. If you need help or...
Okay, and the winner is... Katriana Oliver for Hacked. Don't patronize me, Mr. Wayland. Yeah. Gonna make a little speech.
this movie, director Parker. Theater's always been a big part of my life, but I just wanted to say thank you to everyone for not just Script to Screen, but also just theater in general. Thank you, guys.
All right, the next award is for Best Extra. The nominees are... Joey Christakis, Fight or Flight.
Someone said that you were the guy who's... Shut up. Sit.
The next award for Best Cinematography. The nominees are? Okay.
Will, go get your mother.
Little Will, you stay right here and see just how much of a coward your dad really is.
Award is for Best Editor. The nominees are.
I saw you eyeing my girl. Don't you deny it.
Anticipated. You grab a
Thomas Lee Hughes for this girl named Lucy.
Setting the craziness of us.
I was around when Jesus Christ.
The winner is
at his moment.
Thomas Lee Hughes for this girl named Lucy.
Thank you again. I would like to particularly thank you, Mr. Mullane, for giving me keys to the studio so that I could go in every morning before school and on the weekends to edit this film. Otherwise, it would not have gotten done. So thank you.
All right, the next award is for Best Actress. The nominees are...
What's with the hostility?
Maybe it's because you're trying
action
to take my head off.
Fight or flight.
Action, I don't want to talk to you.
What are you going to talk about?
I don't want to fight you.
Okay.
And Sophia Coppola, the best girl named Lucy.
I seriously think that legend might be true. You said you wouldn't think I'm crazy.
Shoot. Oh, stop this thing. I'm just going to be so pissed.
And the award for Best Actress goes to Sophia Calder.
Thanks everybody for coming. Yeah, I had a great time. Thank you, Leekyu, for casting me. Okay.
All right, the next award is for Best Actor. The nominees are...
This is bullshit. All I did was help Lily with her math.
Omar Rios. Look,
I didn't want to have to do this to you. I always thought you was my friend. But I think it's time the hacking at the school stopped.
Okay. And Tyler Johnson, best girl named Lucy.
I definitely wasn't expecting that to happen.
Yeah, and?
So, are you and Johnny Boyce like a thing?
And the award for best actor goes to Tyler Johnson, best girl named Lucy.
Thanks, Mr. Mullane. Wow, I honestly do not know what to say. Thank you so much, obviously, to Thomas Michael Leekyu for casting me in this film. It's been a pleasure to work with you. Sebastian for shaking his head at all of my horrible jokes. And thank you to Sophia for putting up with me. And a big shout out to the crew and all the and all the other actors. You guys were amazing. Thank you so much.
The next award is for Best Director. The nominees are Jason Mai from Fight or Flight, Act by Margaret Ryan, and this girl named Lucy, Thomas Leekyu. And the winner is Thomas Leekyu for this girl named Lucy.
Thank you.
Best Picture. Best Picture, there we go. The nominees are Jason Mai for Fight or Flight, Parker Bryant for Hat, and Thomas Leekyu for This Girl Named Lucy. And the Best Picture Award goes to
Thomas Lee Q for this girl named Lee.
Hurry up, there's only one more award. If you're having the whole cast come up?
Everyone on this stage for being a part of this project. It was an immense amount of work. It was a lot of work, but all these people put up with me, and I put up with all of them. And I think we should all be proud of the final product. So. Thank you, Mr. Lee and Mr. Weingarten, for running this class tonight.
I might as well say, just in case, this is the people's choice. You voted, so Mr. Weingarten, you want to open up? We're going to find out who won. Just in case. It's a time issue. And the winner is...
this girl named...
So everyone who came out tonight and voted, thank you guys so much. It's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. That is tonight's evening. Thank you very much. And all these pictures can be seen online, so feel free to check them out again and again and again. As well as we're actually sending these pictures to the tallies and communicators and again next year. So who knows, you might be getting another award. All right, good job. Don't forget to send me your emails if you want to judge students, especially the acting class, jim@wakehim.tv. Same thing you guys, okay? If you want to judge next year. Thank you all for coming.